Hello everyone. Today we are going to see how we can conduct virtual classroom through our existing setup of smart classroom. In our smart classroom, we have a projector, computer, and a interactive technology. Correct? So, first of all, for conducting virtual classroom or a webinar or for conferencing, we require one software in our laptop or computer. The software name is, just open Google and type Zoom VC download. When you click on Zoom VC download, just click on the first option, download center Zoom. Correct? When you click on download center Zoom, you will the Zoom website will get open, and in that you have to download first option of Zoom client for meetings. Correct? When Zoom client for meeting, you have to click on download, so automatically the installation exe file will get downloaded. And you can see here downwards, just click on show in folder, and there you will find Zoom installer. Just double click on that and it will get installed in your laptop. So once it is installed, once the software get installed, you can see on your desktop, computer desktop, there will be one icon called Zoom. It looks like a video recording camera and it is written there Zoom, correct? So you have to open that Zoom app. So it will ask for registration. So now it is registered with my account, so that's why it is not asking. Otherwise it will ask, just like we open any Gmail account or Yahoo account, it asks for email ID and password. Like that only you have to first time log in it, correct? If you are not signed in, then you have to enter your email ID, password, username, and all those things are required. Otherwise there are three options to log in with the Zoom. Either you can sign in with the Facebook, you can sign in with the Google account, or you can sign in with Microsoft account. There are three options. So if you are having Google account or a Facebook account, you will get three options to log in or sign in. When you click on Gmail, when you click on Google or Facebook, it will ask for your Facebook or Google account password. So you can just log in with Google account, as I have done with the Google account. Correct? So once you click on login with the Google account, you will find these four options on your desktop: new meeting, join, schedule, or share screen. Correct? So first of all, if you are in a smart classroom and you want to conduct lecture, you by using interactive technology, like interactive technology in the sense whatever you are writing on the board, that will be broadcasted or shared with the student virtually. Correct? So you have to click on share screen. Like suppose I am taking a lecture of human anatomy or a history or a geography, I have to click on share screen, because before the webinar or a video conferencing or a broadcasting, I have to be ready with the PPT or slides or videos and all those things, images on all those things, I have to be ready before the lecture. So once I open Zoom VC software, directly I can click on new meeting or I can click on share screen. When I click on click new meeting, so it will get disconnecting. So once it get connected, it will generate a 10 digit number and a URL which can be shared with the students. Like see here, it will ask join with the computer audio, test speaker and microphone. So just click on automatically join audio by computer when joining a meeting and close it. So here you can see Zoom participant ID 18, meeting ID 9328501400. So 9 digit number is there. Second option to get this ID and URL is here. You can see when you click on this icon, it will show everything like meeting ID, the host, and the password and the URL. So this URL you can just copy and paste it in the WhatsApp group of students, so that they can just click on that URL and they will get connected. Or the second option is just copy this meeting ID and share with the students with the password, so that okay, for connecting like for student, if the student wants to connect through this to this lecture, so they must have a Zoom cloud meeting software in their smartphones, correct? If they are using Android, so they have to go to Play Store and they need to download Zoom Cloud Meeting, correct? If it is a Windows, then they have to download Zoom Client Meeting, and if they are having the iPhone, then they have to download Zoom Client Meeting. But if it is a Android, then they in the Play Store they have to type Zoom Cloud Meeting, so directly they will get join meeting option. So they can when they click on join meeting option, they need to punch in this number 9328501400. So whichever number, every time whenever you will initiate the meeting, the every time the number will be different. So before the lecture you have to share this number, meeting ID and the password, correct? So once it is done, you can just click on share screen. When you click on share screen, just click on the first option and click on share. So once it is done, so now you can see like whatever we will be doing on the board or on the laptop. If suppose I am showing a PPT to the PPT or a video, if suppose I want to show PPT or a video, I will just click on any video or a recording. So whatever I am opening on my desktop, that will be seen to the whole class who is available virtually. So they can see everything whatever I am showing with my audio. So this way we can do virtual classroom. Thank you.